in the NBA. Thanks, everyone, for joining us here in the start of a new season. I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge is joining us from the sideline. We'll see the Memphis Grizzlies and the defending NBA champions, the Los Angeles Lakers. And the Grizzlies start out with the ball. And on opening night, every team starting from scratch, Steve, that has a lot of people optimistic at this time of the year. Teams that favored coming into the season and teams that may not be looked upon very favorably.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, a lot of these teams, they look at it, maybe didn't have the season they wanted the previous season, maybe because of injuries, or maybe they just in jail. So as a organization, a fan base, you're excited in opening day. And then there are some teams, Kevin, that you look in and you go, we don't even have a chance, but let me just pretend like it that we have a chance, and hopefully they can make a trade throughout the year.
Now we'll look at Memphis's starting group. Corey Joseph is out there with Matthews. Then there's Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's Kyle Anderson. And it's Love in at the four slot. And Silk gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Here's Valanciunas, and there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two. And there's the foul against the Lakers.
Like the way that Valanciunas worked his way to the line on that shot. Never let the defender get comfortable.
The Grizzlies shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe. Free throw missing.
For a player his size, Valanciunas has always been a good free throw shooter. We won't see a heck of Val anytime soon.
Good on the second free throw. Here's Stone. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, I had a chance to talk with head coach J.B. Bickerstaff. The one point of emphasis was this is a fast team that they're playing. Their goal is to try and force them into the half court and not to let them run in transition. We'll see if it's successful, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And it's Joseph with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Grizzlies. And, of course, this is the first they're seeing of the Lakers.
Yeah, and these teams pretty familiar with one another. They'll face off four times this year.
These teams have played each other plenty of times over the years. All of these games should be exciting, tight-fisted affairs.
Here's Stone, following the basket by Kevin Love. The rebound by Anderson.
I can tell you right now, the coach loved everything about that shot except the result.
Matthews, no good. For Los Angeles, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Took him no time at all on that one. Stone's got his first bucket of the night.
Point guard skills and a power forward's body. The unique versatility of LeBron James.
Here's Joseph, the dish to Valanciunas. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
He turned on the jets as soon as he got that screen and went right to the hole. Great decision making there.
Puts it up from 12. Joseph with the rebound. Grizzlies have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. To the middle. And the rejection by LeBron.
When he blocks shots, they are usually on the highlight reel. LeBron James with another one.
Here's Harris. The shot from the low post is good.
And where's the help? Obviously a missed rotation. Something they're going to want to patch up.
Only the first quarter. Guys are getting in the groove, but communication on the defense has to be better.
Now here's Matthews. On the clock, Valanciunas, it's deflected. James looking around, goes up the baseline, the second effort, and the rejection by Valanciunas.
Valanciunas, he's got that long wingspan. You saw it right there on that play.
And the dunk by Love.
Oh boy, to be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it? Here's Harris, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up. Wesley Matthews picks one up. Los Angeles shooting their first free throws of the game.
Only 71% from the line last season, and rest assured they're hoping to bring those numbers up this year.
The first free throw is good.
And some think that Harris had an easy path to the league due to his privileged upbringing, but he's proven he belongs.
And Harris drops them both. His leads have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Now here's Joseph, guarded by Stone. Bucket is good.
Absolutely fearless. I mean, a nice subtle adjustment there going up against Wendt.
Well, this is where he shows both skill and body control along with the attack mindset.
Here's James. The Grizzlies making the shot. Pass to Wagner. Dishes to Stone. Beyond the arc. Good on the triple. Stone's got his second bucket of the night.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
Well, obviously, this was the strategy coming in. Feed him the rock and let him go to work.
Now, here's Joseph, 11 feet away. Here's Love, and the layup's good off the glass. Love's got 6 points.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside. You know, watching Kevin Love, he's really got a ton of tools at his disposal offensively. We know he can shoot it. We know he can post it. But his off-ball movement has also improved. Love has molded himself into a dynamic scorer.
Now here's Anderson. After the miss from Corey Harris. Anderson dishes to Joseph. Inside. It's blocked. Kuzma. He's still scoreless so far in this one. LeBron with it. The pass to Kuzma. Just three to shoot. Gets the jumper from the corner to fall.
This is what it means to be a catalyst. His offense helps set the tone for a lot of what they do.
It's Anderson with the drive. The shot off that time. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Here's Stone. Yes, it's James picking up the assist. That's 7 points for Silk.
And on the defensive side, just a failure to match up.
Well, the one thing you want to take away is anything at the rim. Just too easy.
Now here's Anderson. To the wing on the left. Joseph has an open look. Goes back up, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And there's the foul against the Lakers. The Grizzlies shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. Brandon Ingram, he's checked in for Harris. And Memphis also making a switch. Dylan Brooks, he's checked in for Matthews. The Lakers in the lead. Stone kicks to Ingram. Goes to the reverse layup and kicks it in.
And the speed of Ingram makes him a nightmare for defenses in pick and rolls, constantly keeping them guessing.
LeBron against Anderson. And he makes that one. Anderson's got his first 2 points.
And that's just taking advantage of some soft defense on that drive. Little resistance for him on the way to the basket.
Here's Stone, 7 points in the game. Joseph with the rebound.
I appreciate the attack mindset, but with the defense tracking him down, it was probably better to kick that one out. And you see the coach saying, no, no, no. Then yes, yes, yes.
So it's the Lakers now, following the score by Memphis. Ingram kicks to Stone, passes it to James. Over Anderson, gets the 14-footer to fall. LeBron's got his second bucket of the night.
Understanding that defenses are going to guard against the drive, LeBron counters from the mid-range.
Pass to Joseph. Back to Love. Now, here's Joseph. Five to shoot. And it's Love missing. The Lakers have gone 8 of 15 from the field, shooting above 50% here tonight. LeBron passes to Stone. Here's Wagner. LeBron outside. Pass to Kuzma. A three. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. James has got three assists now in this one.
You just love LeBron's patience. Scanning the floor, delivers the basketball on point and on time.
Now, here's Joseph. Down low, here's Brooks. A second chance effort, LeBron with the block. To the paint, stolen by Joseph. Brooks against Ingram, and that one is hammered home.
Whoa, quick hands on the steal, and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and offensively.
Terrific defensive instincts to come away with that one, and he showed no hesitation in how he completed that transition opportunity.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
And you know, you'll take what he can give you from the free throw line. Looking at his numbers, just really not one of his strengths, shooting in the low 60s last season.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Booker, he's checked in for Wagner. Joe Ingles comes in for Kyle Kuzma. And it's Lonzo Ball in for Stone. He hits both from the stripe.
The former Blue Devil, Brandon Ingram, was taken second overall back in 16. Was deemed as untouchable by his front office as they rebuilt the roster. He's a big part of what the Lakers want to do over the next few years.
Los Angeles leading by four. Ball up top. He's covered by Joseph. Ball kicks to James. Lays it up and banks it in. LeBron's got six. And it was Magic Johnson, Greg, who said Ingram is untouchable. Also feels Ingram can be an elite scorer.
Yeah, I mean, Ingram certainly has the makeup and skills to be a first option on offense. And when he heard of how highly Magic thought of him, it made Ingram want to work even harder. You can certainly see the huge leaps he's made as a scorer since Magic kind of gave him that vote of confidence.
They get the rebound. Jackson can't cash in from close range.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint.
And here is Ball. No points in the game yet for him. Floats it up for James. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
How do you stop that? LeBron with too much lift and too much power.
Now the pass to Brooks. James against Anderson. Six to shoot. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. Brooks finds Henson. Buries it down low.
Sometimes you get tunnel vision being that close inside, but he saw the entire court and threw it out to an open teammate.
1:14 left in the first quarter of the game. Anderson against Ingram. From deep three-point range, it's rebounded by Memphis. Left side, Anderson. Back to Joseph. Brooks outside. Right wing from 20 feet out. That's good from Joseph on the assist by Brooks. Now just a four-point Laker lead. LA's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Ball, the pass to Ingram. Kicks it to James. Pass to Ingles from downtown. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
You see the practice time Ingles has put in. Completely in rhythm. No problem with that shot.
Brooks against Ingram. Brooks feeling it out a bit. To the right side. Shoots it.
And the long arms and legs of Ingram come into play on defense, bothering shooters with his hustle.
And so it's Los Angeles, bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They're feeling very confident, shooting the ball with great efficiency and dictating the pace. Back right after this. Being an NBA champion, quite an accomplishment. Here's what winning his first NBA title has meant for AI.
You know, when you're a kid and you think about that moment for so long, like what you say, like how you react and celebrate, everything plays out in your head, you know, like 1,000 times before you even get to the NBA. But there is absolutely nothing that can prepare you for that feeling. I'd say that I had a smile on my face probably till about late July. and that's when I knew that it was time to get back to work so I could feel that elation again.
And Greg, you talk to any of the greats in the NBA, they will all tell you there is nothing that compares to winning that first title.
And to be so crucial to the team winning like AI was in their postseason run last year, that is something special, and he'll always have that with him for the rest of his life.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Lakers here so far, guys.
Protecting that rim early on, that's been a big factor for them tonight.
Well, you can erase a lot of defensive mistakes when you have shot blockers lurking in the background.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. Taking a look at the Grizzlies.